Imagine a world in which all are free. Free of pain, free of hunger, and above all, free of death. Think of a world in which you and your loved ones could live for eternity. The spring of eternity invites you to a place where your emotions will shape a new, better reality. Together we can create a place in which, free from care, we will save our souls. According to our prophecies, our believers patiently waited for 312 years for the next coming of the prophet. A holy man that fortunately has come to us now to share the truth about our lives with us. And just as the first light beams irradiate the darkness of the night, so you can feel the change. One that will bring you out of your numbness. Numbness that you felt your entire life. Our high priest, our prophet. It wasn't by chance that he came here now. He will deliver us from fear. He will deliver us from death, which is not real. In return, we will receive life in the eternal city, which we will shape together with the power of our emotions. Let us feel together the power of the holy fire, one that purifies. A fire in which, if you really believe, will save all of us. Come to the spring of eternity. Come and open your eyes. Open your eyes. Open your eyes.
Their cell at the hour of prayer.
Where's my son?
Eternity civilian employees, you are legally bound to leave the building complex before the 4 p.m. This is the official announcement of the Prophet's office.
Don't let her interrupt the ceremony!
This won't change.
anything. What you've interrupted here, I can finish it on the other side. In the Eternal City. We will ascend as you with your child burn.
Do not fear.
Who are you?
Do not despair. Your son is alive. His body may be lost, but his soul still lingers. And he is still in danger. There is time, though. I will teach you how to find him. Come with me.
Someone from the spring put up Gabriel's obituaries? How dare they? And to think that not so long ago, I believed every word they said. They even mention you after what they did. The spring was supposed to keep us together, not tear us apart.
Teeth this week.
Wait. That's her. Mother of that Gabriel boy.
The one that died in the fire.
Now. The word of the prophet teaches us not to condemn sinners. Still, if it be my son, I pity her. Hope she renounces her ways so they can meet again in the Eternal City.
Is she still standing behind us?
Thank you.
Why did you make me come back here?
Only here will you find what you need.
Tell me, how going through my father's stuff could help me find my son?
Your father believed in the blessed teachings more than you know. Belongings, yours and Gabriel's, are the key here. Find your father's journal.
And then what?
Accept that death can take different forms.
Shouldn't come back here. Kid's gone. Father's gone. There's nothing left for you here.
That is my business, thank you.
A month has passed since the greatest tragedy of recent years. The fire of the headquarters of the Spring of Eternity, which took the lives of 20 people occupying key positions in the organization, including the most important one, the Prophet. All the faithful place flowers
Mom's
and light
photo.
Candles in their windows, praying for
Seems
the victims
like
to pass on peacefully
door.
To the true kingdom.
Hello, Dorothy. I knew you'd find this tape sooner or later. I hope my disappearance didn't make you too sad. I wish I could explain myself, but I don't want to add to your burdens. I've been wondering if you hate me, Dorothy. After all, you wouldn't even be living there if it weren't for our fights. I've been ruminating on my faith lately. Maybe I am to blame.
Dad's final work. No. I don't want to look at this. So this is his journal. These pages are filled with notes on rituals, crossings, visions. What was this madman up to? Here, the last page. Speaks of a ritual of passage. To enter the Eternal City is to sacrifice one's memories, one's past. Three objects, three tokens of three relationships are to be sacrificed. Gabriel's hair. Dad made a thing of cutting it himself. Now I'm glad he did it. It's the last piece of my son that's left. A weird man. But I guess he loved his grandson in his own way. With this, I accept the Eternal City and its throne. With this, I sacrifice who I am and what I own. I submit my past and those who define me to experience the life eternal, untimely. Where am I? What is this music? Why is the doorknob gone?
Don't leave me, Mommy.
Gabriel? Stop!
No! Why are you doing this to me? What monsters will you protect me from now? Anybody here? Where did you bring me? Where is Gabriel?
My child, you are on a road to a world where memories and emotions shape the realm. It is you who brought us here.
Then why is Gabriel not here?
Because he is trapped in the Eternal City. Powerful forces have imprisoned him in the monastery. Yet do not despair. You are still weak, but there are things that will help you. Approach the altar.
I don't understand.
This mask is your strength. It will guard you from sorrow. Put it on.
If I do this, will I see my son?
Yes, you will. This mask will protect you from the effect the city has upon its people.
every new believer had to wear that thing. But here, damn, cult's reach is unbelievable. Crystal, it resonates with strong emotions, fear and surprise. You don't need it anymore. Some kind of gas. It burns! I need to get to high ground before this gas kills me. What are they trying to make here? Seems like the ladder leading up is stuck. Why does the whole fucking world always resist?
Finally, you have arrived.
This place looks terrible, but also familiar.
The Eternal City reacts to its people's emotions. If they are at peace, so is the city. And so, great emotions can conjure things into existence.
Then why is everything destroyed? This looks like punishment, not freedom.
When the plague appeared, so did fear. They did not know how to fight it, and in their fear, they brought this upon themselves. Then came the High Priest. With fire, he seared the plague and those who opposed him. The masks were created to strip away fear, but they stripped away people's humanity instead. Your mask is unique. It will allow you to possess the power of the other masks.
How? Show me. Is this one of those masks?
Yes. A common token of subjugation. All who wear them feel no fear, but turn into subservient tools.
Okay, broken mask in. Changed. Not just the mask. I can sense it's different.
Now, see what is hidden. You will go where others cannot.
You better watch yourself! The guards are patrolling this district!
As the city dies, my resolve strengthens.
Shit! I've gotta hide. Quick!
Stop right there, citizen!
There's gotta be a place to hide here!
Your luck will soon run out.
paid for to play.
Not her again.
Move along.
Yes. Follow me. The purging of the sector will begin soon. Submit yourselves to the fire of our faith.
Close the gate.
You asked me why I am helping you. Before the new prophet arrived, I was the one who ruled the Eternal City.
You are responsible for what happened?
No, my child. You interrupted the High Priest's ritual, leaving the prophet with no strength to fight the plague. You are responsible for this.
I was saving my son! I'm not interested in your prophets or guilt!
Yet you are at the heart of this conflict. Remember what you have learned. There are still shrines in the city which will help you. The tokens from your past. They can be sacrificed here so that your mask will be blessed. You still have time to remedy your mistake.
There's a solemn aura surrounding this crystal. A feeling of woe.
As you know, the plague is upon our city. Those who know me know of the sacrifices I made for the people. And just as my son, the prophet, we must obey our teachings and renounce that which holds us back. Let our pain be our immolation. Let fire be where we find solace. Let the cleansing begin.
Mother Superior, the sacred sadist. This should help me to shut down the incinerator pump.
My child, do not fear. I will guide you. Follow my voice. Calm your emotions.
Thank you. You ran away from me so many times, yet you always returned.
And so she was gone, like everyone else. It was all her fault. She had to choose, but she always chooses wrong.
You were supposed to be obedient to your father, to your faith, mindful to the teachings. It's no mystery why the boy had constant nightmares with a mother like that.
What is my father doing here? I thought all of this was behind me.
Evidently, you cannot forgive yourself for what happened.
Forgiveness? You really want to talk about it now?
Yes, we shall speak of it. Memories of your father are holding you back from what is important, from your son. Show mercy to your father and leave.
But even these items, they remind me of him.
So use them to your advantage. Return to the city where you are needed.
With this, I accept the Eternal City and its throne. With this, I sacrifice who I am and what I own. I submit my past and those who define me to experience the life eternal, untimely.
Shit, I need to watch out for those mines so I don't end up as this poor man here.
Thank you. Oh.
Thank you! Thank you! I welcome nothingness.
Daddy? Is that you?
Your time is running out, my child.
These vines, they look like they will devour the whole city.
And so they will. As long as the High Priest and Gabriel are caught up here together, the plague will ravage the land.
Why is Gabriel being held in that church?
He is being prepared for the new ritual. The High Priest is almost ready.
And this place? Why are you here?
Here, you will see what kind of a man the High Priest really is. What will happen to the city under his rule. The High Priest has always wanted only one thing, total obedience, rejection of everything that was before his arrival. I have already told you. Here, people can bring into existence things that were of great importance to them. He wanted the people to reject it all, to love and fear only him.
Delayed. This is the consequence of your fear and lack of faith. Plague is a test of character and devotion to the spring of eternity. The mask grants freedom from fear. The mask grants freedom from emotions.
Was there no other way?
The High Priest chose the path of absolute obedience. The only path he knew. The masks have created perfect subjects. All opposition has vanished.
Interrogation reference number DO/1916. Why are you refusing to wear the mask?
Because there's no fear in me.
Are you not afraid of the plague? Of disobedience towards the Prophet?
I'm not afraid of the truth. Truth that your priest is not the real Prophet. I've seen the painting of Linda the Elder.
Linda? The Elder? But how? This looks like my father's painting. Did I bring it here?
As I said, your father was a man of deep faith. Deep, but warped. He brought it here. This painting has given people hope.
Hope? Hope for what? That a child will save them?
Hope for salvation and redemption. Hope that a mother will save her child and then save them. Much is expected of you. And even more will be.
Help me understand this, please. You can't ask me to do this alone. Father, but how?
Trapped here and I cannot get out.
Who are you?
I'm just a simple technician. I was trying to pump out the gas at this place and now I'm stuck. There's no way out of here till the gas is all pumped out.
Then I need to help you, no matter what I want. Fine, what do I have to do?
Good. A pump is already plugged in, but it's missing two parts. They're somewhere here in this area. Look for them. Then you need to install them and start the generator. On your right side, there's a technical room, but look out for plague. The air there is poisonous. Last thing, try to pull the fence leading to my building. If you don't, the pressure will pump gas into here. There's a lever controlling the fence next to my house. Good. Now look at the next one. Please remember about closing the vent to my building.
Thank you.
pressure gauge!
There should be a big lever near the wall.
Thank you.
It's tingling. But not in an unpleasant way. I better hide this crystal quick.
The power of the spring unleashed.
litany of pain teaches us patience.
Is that the plague?
Who's there? You shall perish.
My sister's beat me.
Is clearing the air I breathe, and it makes the darkness disperse a little bit.
You can feel the prophet. You can feel his voice. Do you hear it? It's so beautiful.
I should have listened to the guards.
I should have messed with the plague.
I'm ready to repent.
Save us from the plague! Hail the Great Mother!
the last chain. Is the monument secure?
Yes, sir. We had to attach one to the gates. But the construction... it is still unreliable.
You better...
Finally, we
can end this.
I remember you.
As you should. Such a nobody. But you were able to disturb our ritual. Impressive for a daughter of an alcoholic. Now, just as he, you will die here.
Come with me.
Oh no, not this again. First time he told me about his nightmares. Please be empty.
Nothing we can do. According to our tests, he's a perfectly healthy boy, so...
But he is getting worse. These nightmares.
Once again, I'm sorry.
After this call, I started to look for alternative methods to help Gabriel.
Come here.
Wait, why isn't my flashlight working?
Can't you see me? I'm here. It's so dark. I don't want to be here.
Welcome to the Spring of Eternity, Sister Dorothea and Brother Gabriel. I hope you'll find here what you're looking for.
If only I could turn back time.
Come get me, Mom!
This is our library. One day, you will know all these books by heart.
But there are so many of them.
Do not worry. You will have more than one life to do this. This library, the city, all of this will be yours. You should not be here. You are not ready. This is not for you to see.
Finally, you show up. I was wondering where you were hiding now.
My child, you are—
Silence!
Listen.
Silence! I had enough. Understand? I've had enough of you and your bullshit. I'm done with your whole fucking religion. You preach about redemption, yet it's all lies, manipulation. Just like everyone in my life. My father, the sect,
child.
You. No! Stop saying that! This is about my child! Mine! You treat us both as some kind of tools? Fuck you! With this, I accept the Eternal City and its throne. With this, I sacrifice who I am and what I own. I submit my past and those who define me to experience the life eternal, untimely. These doors were closed. Did somebody open them for me?
Mother Superior prepared a proper welcoming for her right there.
Definitely did something. Now on to the second lever. It should be somewhere at the end of the cable. Thank you.
I am sorry. I did not want you to come here.
Then why did you show up?
These writings. This is the entire knowledge of the Spring of Eternity. And also my greatest failure. Because I did not destroy the most vile of them. This knowledge was not meant for anyone. I am sorry, Dorothea.
This would mean that all his dreams, nightmares, those strange voices, that was you all along?
Yes.
Why? Why did you burden a child with this?
It was the only way. I had to teach him. His role required it.
His role? A prophet to your mad religion? I thought that he was sick. I wanted to save him from those nightmares. I took him to the spring, for God's sake. Why didn't they help?
Who wants to be proved wrong?
Possession? He wanted to be reborn as Gabriel. I can't.
Yes. He wants to devour Gabriel's soul and possess his body. He will usurp his life and his role.
How can we undo this?
There is no undoing it. If he succeeds, he will become a living god. I am sorry. Now it is up to you. Save Gabriel. Save us all.
enter the control room from the platform next to this crane.
You how this would end.
I know that my son is the true prophet. I know what you are doing to him. The death of my son? The destruction of the city for what? Just so he can win?
So he will become a god.
It's my son, Gabriel, who is the one.
He proved to be valuable. His relation with the plague allowed us to create miraculous things. As you will see down there.
You won't kill me. I'll save my son.
And I will do everything for mine.
Now.
You! Help me! We need to lift the cage up to get out of here!
way beyond the treetop, where you will find the nightmare won't stop.
I don't want to go to sleep, Mommy. I'm scared.
With this, I accept the Eternal City and its throne. With this, I sacrifice who I am and what I own. I submit my past and those who define me to experience the life eternal and untimely.
Preparations are complete. Bring me the child.
Yes, sir.
The prodigal mother returns. I told you, even in death, I will succeed. I will become who I was destined to be, a god. I find satisfaction in knowing you came so close, only to fail to save your son again.
That bitch downstairs said the same thing. And now she's dead.
That is of no significance. When I will ascend, I will be able to shape this reality according to my will. Nothing is lost.
You will never win. I will take my son.
Then please, try. Dispose of her.
Yes, my lord. As you command. I will be with you.
Finally, the ascension is at hand. Prepare to charge! Significant and great again. Behold, as I become a god incarnate.
Please, use what I have taught you. Use your emotions. Use your anger. Use it to destroy him.
Destroy everything that's beyond your feeble comprehension. I will save you all. I will make this place a paradise. Why do you still resist?
What's wrong, Prophet? What happened to your ascension?
You. Come then. Face your God. How can a single woman stop the inevitable?
I'm not just a woman. I am a mother. And I know what you are underneath that mask. You are nothing.
Imagine a world in which all are free. Free of pain, free of hunger, and above all, free of death. Think of a world in which you and your loved ones could live for eternity.
Everything will be all right, Mommy. From now on, I'll be taking care of you. I promise.
Together we can create a place in which, free from care, we will save our souls. Let us feel together the power of the holy fire, one that purifies. A fire in which, if you really believe, will save all of us. Come and open your eyes. Open your eyes. Open your eyes.